Okay, Dr. Mindy here with Dr. Pompa, and we want to talk today with you about probiotics because we've been at this conference for the last 2 days and learning about a new type of probiotic called a neurobiotic and about the importance of your gut to your serotonin levels and your dopamine, and you have a ton of experience with this. So I think the most important thing is let's start off by talking about why your probiotic could be making you worse.
It's true. You know, a lot of people are taking the same probiotic for months, if not over a year.
Yeah.
And something happens called monoculture, where you end up with too many of those specific strains. So if you look at your probiotic, even if you've paid a lot of money for it, it's typically 10 to 20 strains,
yes.
Maybe even less. But the point is you're taking the same strains when there's thousands here. So you're getting an overpopulation of those specific strains, even though they may be good guys. It's still not good because your microbiome is a perfect combination of good guys, bad guys, viruses, etc. So we don't want to overpopulate one species over another.
Yeah, and most probiotics have, what did they say, like the same 23 strains in
yeah.
it? So even if you're switching around, you're still getting that monoculture.
Yeah, I mean, when you look at the marketplace, everyone brags about their different probiotic, but they're using typically the same 10 biotics. Bacteria, right? So even when they switch, they're still getting the same 10 bacteria,
right.
And that's a problem. It's not good. And by the way, then you add the people drinking the kombuchas and things, and again, they can monoculture as well, and we've learned now that it's not good. And here's the thing that happens. People take it in the beginning, and they get a positive effect,
right.
So they
yep.
just keep taking it because
right.
they think it helps them, and now it's working against you.
Right,
ultimately.
Right, yeah. right. So, and what the conference we've been at has been discussing is the importance of the gut bacteria for your mental health.
Yeah.
So talk a little bit about nobody ever thinks I'm depressed, I should take a probiotic.
Right.
So
yeah.
explain that correlation
yeah,
for people.
Yeah, I mean, we know now, right, in the last 10 years especially, bacteria here, we need to make certain neurotransmitters. Those are things your brain uses to be normal, right? Serotonin, dopamine, feel good. Type of hormones, if you are neurotransmitters. So we need bacteria to make them. You don't just make them here, you actually make them here.
Mm-hmm.
But you need certain bacteria to do that. And when we don't have enough, and by the way, a lot of toxins today, drugs, medications, destroy those bacteria.
Mm-hmm.
So what are we doing? We have a population of people who are depressed, have anxiety, sleep disorders, hormone problems. And what are they doing? They're taking medications. Then that's not the answer.
You're destroying it.
Absolutely, even more. Instead
like,
of saying, wait a minute,
yeah.
you know, here we have a population of people who lack certain bacteria to actually make certain neurotransmitters or chemicals that our brain needs to function normally or for us to feel good.
Yeah, it's such a slippery slope because the ones taking even the antidepressants
right.
don't realize that they're destroying the microbiome
right.
that produces the chemicals they need to make their brain work. Right.
Yeah.
So it's just a vicious cycle. So let's talk about the neurobiotic. So this is the first ever, I like psychobiotic, I think you like
yeah,
it
yeah,
too.
Yeah, I like that.
We just learned about the first ever in the world psychobiotic,
yeah.
which is specific strains of bacteria that will actually change how your gut bacteria produce these happy
yeah.
chemicals that make your brain work normal.
About 4 years ago, I spoke on stage here and I spoke about how fecal microbial transplants, okay, that's where you take another healthy person, that's very important, poop, we can say poop, right?
Yeah.
All right, so you understand what we're talking about, and you literally insert it, if you will, through an enema, and what it does is it gives us certain bacteria that you can't get or buy in a store in a pill. So I said, listen, there's other countries that are doing this, and it's shutting off autoimmune. It's changing depression, anxiety, because there's certain bacteria we can't get in a pill, at least at that time, bacteroides species. So my thing is we're working on a pill right now to isolate these human strains that we would once have to get an enema from somebody else's strains, but now we don't have to do that. So it's taken about 4 years to basically isolate and grow some of these human strains. And you're right, this is the first product ever to do that. Now, the biochemist that developed it has been working on it for at least 10 years
right.
to get to this point now to where we don't have to do these human fecal microbial transplants, but we have something that we can actually take in a pill that's, you know, from human strains, these very unique bacteria that we need for our brain to work normal.
Yeah, and the stories we heard today of people who were in the test group are pretty profound.
One called it her happy pills.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, because she literally started taking it immediately and immediately was like, oh my gosh, I mean, I didn't, she didn't even realize she was in the dark, and it just lifted her mood. Literally within a day or two, you heard the testimony as well as I. So.
Yeah, and I think the one that really hit me was the at the end was about the teenager, the soccer player who had suicidal thoughts.
Yeah.
You know, you and I have had that conversation a lot about the teen anxiety and the depression that that generation is going through. And what if it was as simple as changing the microbiome and getting the right bacteria in there? I mean, that's profound.
Yeah, I mean, caution. I mean, we don't want our kids to continue to eat foods that are loaded with this chemical called glyphosate. Mm-hmm. It will keep destroying these bacteria. But you're right. I mean, taking these bacteria that we're missing, especially the younger generation, driving the epidemic of anxiety, depression, and everything we're seeing, you know, that's part of the answer. Avoidance is the other part. We have to clean up our diet and do these things. But yeah, I mean, this is, it's a game changer. I mean, look, you know, millions of dollars are being spent right now on developing these types of bacteria. You know, we're blessed to have a product that's really unique in the marketplace right now, a first.
So, okay, and then one last question, because this came up in my resetter group. I posted a thing about how when you hug somebody or you touch somebody, that you're exchanging bacteria. So, and a bunch of people in the group were like, a bunch of people in the group were like, what? Explain that. So, yeah.
Well, I think it's still in vogue, believe it or not. Every church, school, right, hand sanitizers. Believe me, it's creating more problems than you think we're solving. When you do that, you're destroying the microbiome. So much of our microbiome is on our skin. You know, and it really is good to be more diversity, the better. In human contact, you are sharing microbiome,
right?
And you know, you become, matter of fact, when we look at households, you typically have a very similar microbiome.
Yep.
Healthy household, healthy bacteria, right? So, you know, I'm gonna hang out in your house.
Yeah, that's why I'm like on my husband. I'm like, have you taken your probiotic? Because it's affecting me.
Absolutely. You share your microorganisms.
Right. Yeah. Absolutely.
So everyone in the house needs this.
Yes. Yeah. So if you want to fix your kids' microbiome, start with your own.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then hug them a bunch.
Yeah.
Like, there's one way to go about it.
Yeah.
So.
And stop the sanitizers. I mean, honestly, I mean, the soaps you want, natural soaps. A lot of the soaps you buy, they're antibacterial. Stop all antibacterial soaps, hand sanitizers, all that stuff. You are destroying your microbiome. And what we've learned is that this microbiome affects this microbiome. This microbiome affects this microbiome. So it all is
We're more bacteria than we are human cells. I think people are kind of waking up to that little by little.
Not to go down this road, but your bacteria literally turns on good genes and turns off bad genes when you have a good bacteria. But
it's crazy. Exactly. So if you want to know about the neurobiotic, the new psychobiotic one that we have that helps you produce more serotonin and dopamine, just put neurobiotic in the comments and we'll send you some info. Otherwise, we're excited. This is a game changer for health. I mean, absolute game changer. So we're excited to share it with you.
You're all blessed to be with her, that's for sure.
Thank you. Awesome.
Yeah, yeah.